السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. Welcome dear brothers and sisters. إن الحمد لله أحمده تعالى وأستعين به وأستغفره وأستهديه وأعوذ بالله العلي العظيم من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. الله سبحانه وتعالى Almighty عز وجل said in the Holy Quran سورة آل عمران كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس تأمرون بالمعروف وتنهون عن المنكر وتؤمنون بالله. الله سبحانه وتعالى said indeed you are the best nation أخرجت للناس. You are the best nation being sent to the people by Allah سبحانه وتعالى. We are the ummah of khairat. We are the good ummah. But some of us they have certain characteristics which they've been loved or the most beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from amongst us. In this hadith of Karz al-Khaza'i, that Bedouin guy, he came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he asked Rasulullah, Ya Rasulullah, هل هذا الإسلام منتهى? The Islam just gonna be in the land of Arabia? رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said من يريد الله به خيرا من عرب أو عجم أدخله الله في الإسلام. If Allah سبحانه وتعالى wants خير good to anybody Arab and non-Arab they will be Muslims, they will accept الإسلام, they will love الإسلام. That Bedouin man asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, Ya Rasulullah, and then what gonna happen? If the Islam will be outside the land of Arabia, what gonna happen? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, after that it will be lots of fitan, trials, afflictions, killings, temptations, lots of fitna. Fitna will come. And Muslims, they will kill each other. The Bedouin man said, كلا والله يا رسول الله قسم by Allah, O Rasulullah, that will never gonna happen. This is what he used to know, that Bedouin guy. But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, بلا والذي نفسي بيده. He swears by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, that fighting, that killing, that fitna, it will happen. This is what Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, and he said, لَتَعُودُنَّ فِيهَا أَسَاوْدَ صُبَّا. And Muslims during that time, they will be like the snakes. The snakes, when the snake attack its victim or the farisa or subhanallah, you see the snake stand and attack one time like that. أَسَاوْدَ صُبَّا. You're going to attack your farisa or your victim. He said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam during the time of temptations and the killings and the trials and all of that, فَخَيْرُ النَّاسِ يَوْمَئِذٍ, the best amongst you during that time, Rasulullah said, مُؤْمِنٌ مُعْتَزِلٌ يَتَّقِ اللَّهِ. A mu'min, a believer, a believing man or a believing woman, they are away from everybody. اعتزال, مُعْتَزِل, مُعْتَزِل. And while he is doing his prayers, going to the masjid, just he's not dealing a lot with people, subhanallah, just he's very quiet and he has a fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. While he's doing that, وَيَذَرُ النَّاسَ مِن شَرِّهِ, he's not harming anybody. The best amongst us during the time of the temptation, killing, fitna, the one he is not harming anybody with his tongue and with his hand. And this is Islam, the reality of Islam. قال المسلم من سلم المسلمون من لسانه ويده. The real Muslim, which is everybody, is safe from what? From the harm of his tongue and from the harm of what? His hand. This is what he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the most beloved to Allah amongst us, خير الناس, the best. He said, إن الله يحب العبد التقي الغني الخفي. Indeed, Allah loves His servants while He is taqi. He has taqwa in His heart. He is pious. النقي. He is pure inside and outside. Cleanless. Purification. التقي. النقي. الخفي. الخفي. He is hiding his good deeds. Whatever good he is doing, he's hiding that. He's not showing off. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, talk about those who are giving sadaqah, charity, secretly and openly, during the night and during the day. الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ بِاللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ سِرًّا وَعَلَانِيَةً فَلَهُمْ أَجْرُهُمْ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ وَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. The most beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, dear brothers and sisters, amongst us, those who are very beneficial to others. You see somebody, he's in calamity, go help him. Somebody in hunger, thirsty, go help him. Somebody in sickness, go help him. Somebody in debt, go help him if you can. Try to help your brothers. Wallahi, if you walk with your brothers in his affairs, you're trying to help him. Even you do it or not, that's better than i'tikaf in the masjid of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for a month. One rak'ah, unit of prayer, rak'ah in the masjid of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, equal to 1,000 rak'ah in any masjid around the world. Imagine if you're making i'tikaf for 1 month, how many rak'ah is you going to do? And your dua, you are close to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you help your brother in Islam, in his affairs, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help you. And that kind of Muslim, he is very weak. I'm not saying weak, he's very humble. He's down to earth. He's humbling himself. That kind of Muslim, maybe he comes to the masjid. Maybe he walks in the street. Maybe he's your neighbor. And nobody even feel he is there, because he's so humble. He's very polite. He's following the etiquettes of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. His heart full of mercy and rahmah. That kind of Muslim, nobody cares about him. Nobody even knows he is there. لو أقسم على الله لأبره الله. If he make a qasam to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala will fulfill his qasam. Subhanallah. And Rasulullah, brother, sister, say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Said in the authentic hadith narrated by Imam al-Bukhari, rahimahullah, may Allah have mercy on him, خيركم, the best amongst you, من تعلم القرآن وعلمه, the one who learns the Quran and teach it to others. The best amongst you, the one who learns the Quran and teach it to others. The معلم القرآن, the متعلم of the Quran, the one who learns the Quran and the one who teaches the Quran to others. And I have a good surprise for all of you now. Dear brothers and sisters, our kids, our daughters, our sons, subhanallah, I have a good surprise. I have one of the biggest qari', one of the good qari' from Egypt, Sheikh Shamsuddin. He is with me in the studio now. Inshallah, wait for him. He will, in the part of the Quran, inshallah, he will recite, inshallah, Quran, and you're going to listen, you're going to enjoy his recitation. To be the one of the best, learn the Quran and teach it to others. And he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the best amongst us, khayarukum ahasinukum akhlaqa, the one who has perfect and good manners. Good manners to be generous, to have shyness, to have haya, to have good etiquette, good morals, good conduct with others. This ahasinukum akhlaqa. And if you want to be the neighbor of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Jannah, you have to have good akhlaq and good manners. Not just that. If you want your scale of hasanat, good deeds, to be heavy, you have to have taqwa Allah and husnul khuluq. He said sallallahu alaihi wasallam, khiyarukum ahsanukum qada'a. If somebody give you a loan or somebody qurda hasana or anything like that, give him his money back in very nice way. And he said sallallahu alaihi wasallam, khayrukum man yurja khayruhu wa yu'man sharruhu. The best amongst you, the one you can expect from him khayrat, good things, all good. And also the one which is, you will be safe, everybody safe from his harm and his evil, the evil of his tongue, the evil of his harm of his tongue and his hand. That person will be the best also. If you cannot make good deeds, brothers and sisters, don't harm others. This is Islam. Al-Muslimu man salima al-Muslimuna min lisanihi wa yadihi, wa man salima al-Nasu min lisanihi wa yadihi. And he said that hadith, sahih, authentic, Ibn Hibban narrated that hadith, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, khayrukum khayrukum li ahlih, the best amongst you, the one he is so generous and he is very honorable person to his family. He's honoring his wife. He's good to his wife and his kids. He's so generous with them. He's the best. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I am the best. He was the best, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He used to help Aisha in the kitchen. He used to fix his shoes. He used to clean the house. He used to fix, sew his clothes. He used to fix too many things. He used to milk the sheep. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He used to do a lot of good things. He used to help his wife. He was so nice, kind, gentle with her. This is advice for everybody. And they said, the best amongst you. خَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ أَطْعَمَ الطَّعَامَ وَرَدَّ السَّلَامِ. The one who is feeding others, those who are not hungry, those who are already satisfied, content, no. The one who is feeding those who are in need. The poor, the miskeen, the orphans, those who are weak in our community. The one who's taking care of this kind of people, he's one of the best. And the best also amongst you, the one, whenever somebody saying assalamu alaykum to him, he said wa alaykum assalam. The one who answer assalam, I say alaykum assalam. And he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, khayarukum alyanukum manakib fi salah. Khayarukum in the salah, in the row, when the muazzin makes the iqamah. And subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is looking at your faces and giving you a smile. Also, you have to give room to your brothers in the row of the prayer. In your namaz, in the row, in the masjid, when you in Salat al-Jama'ah, be kind and nice and hold your brother from his hand with a smile. Give him room. That kind of person, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves him so much. And he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in general, khayrukum, the best amongst you, the one which is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala almighty, gives him long life while he is doing good deeds. خَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ طَالَ عُمْرُهُ وَحَسُنَ عَمَلُهُ. Ya salam. The one Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives him long life, in the same time, he is what? Doing righteous good deeds. This is the best. Imagine that you became 80, 70, 80, 90, while you're still going, making khayrat, making good deeds, giving charity to the masjid, giving mushaf to the masjid, looking for the poor and the needy, and you are putting your hands into many ways of khayr or making good, like what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described. Prophet David, he said, وَدَاوُودَ ذَا الْأَيْدِ إِنَّهُ أَوَّابٌ. Sayyidina Dawood, this is yad in Arabic. Two hands. Aydi, more than three, more than two. It's called Aydi, one, two, three. Allah described, he gave one of the characteristics of Sayyidina Dawood, Prophet David, he has too many hands. In what? In making good. Khayrat. In making khayrat. And he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the best amongst you, the one, he is the best to his company, his friend. The one who is the best to his neighbor. And your neighbors, according to the Quran, they are three. He's one of your relatives, your neighbor, and he's Muslim. He has three rights upon you. The right of Islam, neighborhood, and the kinship. Second type of neighbor, he's not one of your relatives, and he's your neighbor, and he's Muslim. He has two rights. The right of Islam and the right of the neighborhood. And the third types of neighbor, he has one right, the right of the neighborhood, because he is not one of your relatives and he is not even Muslim, but he's still your neighbor. He has the right of neighborhood. You have to respect him. According to the Quran, Allah said, وَالصَّاحِبُ بِالْجَنْبِ وَالصَّاحِبُ بِالْجَنْبِ. Very important. قَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهُ وَسَلَّمُ. I will finish with this before we come to the time of the recitation of the Quran. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the authentic hadith, he said, خير الناس ذو القلب المخموم واللسان الصادق. The best amongst the people, the one who has قلب مخموم. قلب المخموم and اللسان الصادق, which is the one he's honest. Whenever he speaks with honesty. He's not a liar. And they said, يا رسول الله, the honest person, اللسان الصادق, we know him. What is القلب المخموم? القلب means the heart. المخموم, the Sahaba, they did not get it. And the Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, القلب المخموم, that kind of heart, النقي, the pure heart, التقي, the one whose heart full of taqwa, There is no sin in it. There is no transgression. There is no hatred. There is no jealousy in it. There is no envy in that heart. And it's very important. If you look to the whole entire Quran, Allah Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking to your heart in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking to your heart. More than 40,000 nerve cells, more than 40,000 nerve cells in your heart for understanding. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لَهُمْ قُلُوبٌ لَا يَعْقِلُونَ بِهَا. The understanding through your hearts, not through your brain. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the whole entire Quran is talking to your heart. And then he said, إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. Except to those who come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those who comes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with what? With pure heart, healthy heart. I'm not talking physically, no, I'm talking spiritually. I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from amongst those, his ummah, to make us from the best amongst his ummah. Ameen ya arhamar rahimeen. Now inshallah, Rabbil Alameen, after this short break, we're going to have Sheikh Ali Shamsuddin. Be ready, carry your mushaf, be ready to recite with us Quran now inshallah, Rabbil Alameen, the rest of the time. And inshallah, you're going to get more hasanat, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Stay tuned. I am with you.